Hello everybody, I thought I'd do a little Middle Aisle video, and this was £17.99, or was it £16.99, I've forgotten now, one of the two, and this was £1.79, and it wasn't quite £2, this is starting off well, isn't it? I'm going to review this first, but before I do, everything from Lidl that's electrical or electronic has a 3-year guarantee on it, but does anyone take anything back to Lidl? Because who do you go to? Do you go to the insanely busy cashier on the tills who's scanning everything through at a billion miles an hour like at Aldi? Or do you go and annoy the insanely busy stock shelf refiller? There's no one to really go to, is there? So, have you ever took anything back to Lidl? Let me know in the comment section down below. Scrass! I usually say that at the end, don't I? Scrass, bye! Anyway, I'm going to start with this first. It's an LED nightlight. great for corridors, stairs or bedrooms. I know they said bathrooms then. With a blue LED for pleasant, subtle lighting. I love the word subtle. It's got a subtle letter B in there that you don't sound or acknowledge. Especially long-lasting, energy-saving. Operating voltage 230 to 240 volt, 50 Hz. LED power, blah, blah, blah. This item is not a toy. Keep out of reach of children. Well, that's going to be quite difficult since it's going to be plugged into a wall. Oh, well. It don't really matter anyway because in the UK we have good plugs, which makes them nice and safe. Sorry if I go a bit John Ward on your bigclive.com, but this is plastic because obviously it doesn't need to be earthed. It's just a nightlight. None of this is metal, for instance, that's why. And these sheaths on here stop you from accidentally touching it as you're plugging it into a switch on the wall that's turned on. But even then, a socket on the wall that's turned on. But we have switches on our sockets, so that reduces the risk as well. And once it's in, these can't go in until the shutter's on the top. Get my little Middle Aisle adapter here. So when you pour it in, the only way these will go in is if this top bit goes in first, the earth wire, and then it goes in like that. Nice and safe. Lots of safety. However, only just yesterday, I did actually stand on a plug. And it effing kills. It absolutely stings. Here's a picture. And that's not the worst time I've stood on a plug either. It's really rare that it happens. I think last time I stood on a plug was about 6 or 7 years ago. In the last place that I lived, so you sort of learn early on that when you unplug anything from a socket on the wall, you make sure it's against the wall. But I think I must have been in a bit of a rush and unplugged the lamp and stood on it. Anyway, let's read on. Should the nightlight become damaged, dispose of it in accordance with the regulations currently in force. You see, it says that, but everyone just chucks it in the bin. I know you shouldn't, but everyone does. And I think they should make recycling a bit more easier for electronic stuff and electrical stuff. Suitable for domestic use only. Yeah, well, like, anyone's going to take it to work with them. Suitable for indoor use only. Okay. I don't know why you'd want a nightlight outside, but hey-ho. Remove packaging prior to use. Oh, yeah, because someone's going to... Oh, yeah, let's plug this into my wall like this, shall I? Let's... Oh, yeah. I mean, who's going to have that sticking out the wall like this? Let's just cover over unnecessarily the socket next to it. Silly. Sometimes I think people are just paid to fill this up as much as possible. The light source of this lamp is not replaceable. Well, that's daft, isn't it? That's just a waste of plastic. When the light source has reached the end of its service life, the entire lamp must be replaced. The entire thing, it means. This item is a light decoration. Do not use for room illumination. Oh, yeah, because you're really going to read a book using this, aren't you? If it is a special product, oh, it's special. As the colour value elements lie outside the ranges listed in brackets, colour value element, blah, blah, blah. Retain future packaging. No one ever retains future packaging. Keep out of reach of children. Again? To keep out of reach of children? Now, I am sure someone's just paid to fill this up. Let's get it open. Enough yakety yak. It's the inside. I went for the shell effect. There's loads of different ones. I didn't know it was like that, though. Like, it's like hollow. Well, that's a bit crappy. I went for the shell one because it reminded me of the petrol station shell. But there was other things, such as there was a planet. I think it was meant to be Earth, but it didn't resemble Earth at all. You know, the land. It just looked really random. So I'll just say it was a planet. Oh, there was all sorts. Let's plug it in and see how bright it is. It's quite bright. I'll take it into a darker room so we can see it. I don't think it's fused or anything, though. It should be, shouldn't it? Oh, no, we'll have to go be clavin' it, because I'll have to open it up, won't I? And see if it's fused. It's quite nice. If it's not coming across on camera, it's mainly the outside that's lighting up, not so much the inside. I think that's because the light is, the LED is just there, look. It's not actually shining through it. It doesn't look like it's fused. Does it need to be fused? Ugh, where's Big Clav when you need him? Yeah. 230 volts, 240 volts. I don't know that I'd work in America. You know, if you put an adapter on this and put it in America, what would happen? I don't know. I just don't know. Because I've stared directly into the blue LED, I've got a blue light in my eyes now. I can still see it turned on. Anyway, let's move all this out the way for now. And move on to this, which is a temperature station. Why do people in Lidl open stuff and ram it back in the box like that? Fucking annoys me. Well, there's another thing. Looks like a bit like one of them doorbells, doesn't it? You know, them ring doorbells. And what batteries have they given us? Ooh! They've given us some Maxell ones. I mean, obviously they're not a good brand or anything, but it's just a brand that I actually do recognise. Usually it's some obscure make. Oh no, fixing screws. Got to fix something apparently. Right, so I'm going to pause now and I'm going to read the instructions and see if there's anything hilarious or something that I've missed. I didn't really get past the safety instructions about how to use flipping batteries. Like, I don't know how to use batteries and loads of exclamation marks. Anyway, I'm going to start putting in some. It's got one of them sort of film things on the front. I just love doing that. I'm going to put the batteries in. So it's radio controlled temperature thing, so you know how cold it is outside. Now, I'm not a really big person of watching the weather because A, I live in the UK, which means generally it's very hot in the summer, cold in the winter, and a bit of in between in autumn and spring. I very rarely watch the weather. I know that if it's summer, it's generally going to be hot, with the occasional thunderstorm or bits of rainy weather. And in the winter, it's going to be cold, but I love the cold. And potentially snowy. Yet it seems to catch the media and the news people out all the time. The weathermen out all the time. Oh. Thanks for the beep. That's going to have to be set up, isn't it? That's quite a nice display, that. It's quite clear. It does the time, the date, and the there's the inside temperature. So it's 23. It's bloody boiling in this kitchen. You see, my favourite temperature inside is about 18 to 19 degrees. So I'm really warm right now. I do have swercles. I do get pressure of the camera as well. I do feel like I'm under the weight of the camera when I do a YouTube video, so I get a bit warm doing videos as well, which doesn't help. And I even hit that feeling of the heat from the sun on my skin. Pretty sure I'm a vampire. Pretty sure of it. But like one of them stupid modern ones where I can actually go out in daylight still. That's convenient, isn't it? Right, so that's on. I think, did I put them batteries in the right way? Have I been dense? Yeah, they're in the right way. Yeah. I thought for a bizarre moment, then I put them in the wrong way. So that's the outside temperature thing. I better put the back on this. Yeah, several pages, including loads of exclamation marks, are how to use batteries and what to do and what not to do with batteries. It's like, I don't know how to make batteries anymore. It's good that the it's starting to flash now. It's good that the it's starting to work, look. And so far, it's different, even though they're right next to each other. There's a degree difference. Well, that's not very good, is it? Well, it's working, though, in the sense that it's turned on. Maybe it was a meander for a bit longer, so maybe they're leaving out in a minute. It's good that it comes with alkaline batteries as well, though, because so many things come with zinc batteries, zinc chloride batteries, which are just terrible. They don't last very long. But this is really good. I think lots of companies now that do supply batteries with stuff are just automatically going to alkaline. There's no reason for zinc batteries anymore. There's probably loads of people now saying, oh, zinc batteries are very good, blah, 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 blah. But I've never heard anything good about zinc batteries. They're just so prone to leaking. I'm not going to fix this to anything at all. Is it evening out yet? No, there's a blooming hell entire degree 0.1 difference. That's no good, is it? In fact, that's the worst way around. I mean, I'd forgive it if it was a degree up inside. Or is that a degree lower? Oh, yeah. Is this just a degree lower? We don't know. I'm absolutely roasting. So warm. Anyway, I'm going to have a bit more of a faff about with it and set the time and everything so it's correct. Be back in a bit. I don't know why I'm saying that. Well, I'm halfway through setting it up. And look at the days. It's not in English. It's in probably German. I don't know what V is. I'm going to have to learn German to use this. Saturday, I think, is the same. S-A. D-O, what's that? Do day. Lu day. Ma day. Me day. G day. V day. So, this is stupid. Oh. maybe it's giving me German temperatures as well, you know. That's a bit daft, isn't it? See, numbers international. You know, numbers you can get away anywhere because they're just the same everywhere. And, but everything else, no. This is stupid. Well, anyway, it's the 20th. It is very loud, isn't it? This bibbing. So it's the 20th day. Oh, I still need to do the month. But yeah, very, very annoying. Well, apparently it's me day. Very precise, German preciseness. And look, it's counting down the seconds to the minutes. You don't normally get that on a LED clock, do you? You do. I mean, I've already got a clock that does that. But you know what I mean, don't you? Something this small. What else was I going to say? Yeah, so this is very precise, if a bit German. People are always banging about German efficiency. Well, yeah, I mean, Germans can do great things like Lidl and Aldi, but they also do terrible things as well, such as the airport. I forgot the name of the airport now, but you've got to look it up. There's this airport that's not been finished getting built after something like 10 years. It's ridiculous. And it's taken so long to build it because it's full of faults and problems. It's took them so long to build it that now it may need to be extended. How bad is that? There you go. Well, obviously now that should prove to you that this video is not endorsed by Lidl. All my videos are just me only. I'm going to have to figure out how to turn the alarm off because I don't want that going off at stupid o'clock. I'm going to put this outside and see what the temperature is like outside. Oh, I'm such a numpty. Apparently, you know what's really good source of information? The instruction books. Yeah, you can actually change the language. You can have German, which it's automatically set to. French, Spanish, Italian, or English. We'll have English. apparently. What have I got to do? I've got to press the set reset button and hold it down. Ugh, what's this? Can you actually reset the temperatures outside? That's weird. Oh, Celsius and Fahrenheit. Well, I'm going to use Celsius like a normal person. So that's that. Oh, God, hang on a minute. Yay, I sorted it. It's Wednesday. Oh, you can see me. Hello. It's Wednesday. Or Wednesday, as some people like to pronounce it. you know, it also helps when you start from number one. You see, I was starting from number four. I'm so terrible at that. Well, now it's working, and I found some sort of button that's supposed to configure the temperature thing, but I've still got a degree and point one difference, which is weird. But there's nothing I can do about that, I don't think. If this is meant to go outside, I'm not overly sure about the weather protection on this. I mean, could this not be made differently to stop water ingress if it was meant to be all big cloud? because I'm sure Big Cloud would have something to say about this, because water's going to get in everywhere on this, I'm pretty sure. It doesn't look particularly water. Maybe not. That doesn't look too bad. But there's nowhere for the water to drain away, because water just gets in everywhere, doesn't it? Now, where to plonk this? I'm just reading more of the book, because I think I should for this, since I've already messed up a few times already. But I do like this bit. You may see the following displays. The temperature is rising. The temperature is... I should say, getting low. Never mind. In fact, before I do find a place to put it, I want to try putting it in the freezer to see if anything changes. It's just changed now, actually, because I've just been holding it tight against me. And I raised it to 25.1 degrees. So we're just going to see now what happens if we put it in the freezer. And there we go. It came down a degree. So it's quite slow. But of course, there's several pieces of wood in the way from the kitchen cupboards and the metal in the freezer. So maybe that's what's making it come down slowly. Oh, actually, how weird is that? It's come down to the same temperature. What are the chances of that? Right, I've put the thing outside now. And it's still going down in temperature. I've put this actual thing on the windowsill, but it is shielded by the cactus from the sun. So hopefully the indoor temperature on the left there won't be affected by the sun too much. And that's the outside temperature. We don't know though what the degree difference is. It might be the inside one, because the clock on the wall which does the temperature says it's 23 degrees. And the thing for the central heating says it's 22 degrees. I've got a 3 degree difference between three things that are quite close together. But the outside one's still going down, so that's good. And that's my review of that. Well, not a review, an unboxing really, isn't it? It's an unboxing. So from me and Michelle and this weather station thing, thanks for watching Scress, and I'll see you when I see ya. Bye!